Hi guys, it's me. Hi. Let me see my lighting. Hold on. Let me try to get some. So, trying to get back into this and learn and try to do better videos. I'm healing. It's been slow and I'm still recovering. There's still a lot that that I still have to face and go through, but I'm definitely at a better place today. Some days I can't focus more than, let's see, if I gotta just learn how to focus in the moment that I'm in, because I tend to overthink and think about everything and just try to, you know, when you start to think. Or you think you have control over everything that you actually, you know, don't. I'm actually getting out with one of my best friends today. We're going to have go to lunch and stuff, which she's coming to get me, and I'm pretty excited about that, guys. Y'all know, a lot of you, and I know I gotta do better. I'm trying to learn how to do better videos and clean stuff up around. It's been definitely a very slow process. Got my wiggies on today, put my makeup on. My hair is still, it's, you know, being treated, and it's just a slow process of getting it back to healing. My feet, you know, nails and stuff, you'd be it's just so weird how some things, illnesses affect your body that you can't come back into. But anyway, guys, I was been, you know, trying to use my brain because I was so worried, you know, between the, what they said was the COVID brain plus the severe malnutrition, starvation that I had. My brain was took a beating, as well as my whole body. Trying to learn how to do everything again is definitely very, very tough. So being able to sit there and start to think about reading again, or listening, or even trying to break down hip-hop songs, that's working my brain, and it helps. There's still a lot I've got to be doing, and still a lot there, long way to go. You know, it started out like with my back, and we've come almost full circle, and I still, that's the issue that we're having to try to work on now. Not to mention, you know, because I already know that I'm going to be on blood thinner for the rest of my life. I have, you know, I cannot be without blood thinner because of my my clotting disorder, plus my thalassemia, which is a rare blood disease that usually I have to go like every three months or so and either get blood transfusions or iron infusions. So I travel to Albuquerque for that, to the cancer center. I have a bunch of my doctors are in Albuquerque. It's so hard because here there isn't much of nothing. Our medical, everything, you know, and obviously, you know, straight up and stuff like that. My medical records are with a malpractice attorney. He's going over everything because of the fact that where we were at this hospital, and they just kept thinking I was going in there for pain medication and stuff, which we had no other choice to go. You know, I was so totally sick, and then no doctor's offices. When they closed the doctor's offices down, and left people with no other choice but to go to the emergency room. And I was declining. And some of the things that one of the doctors had told me that I'm working through in therapy, and they kept dismissing me and saying my life wasn't worth their time. It's a whole tragic story. But I hope all I can do is learn and grow and see what comes about it. I've learned that I have to do things and keep stuff in, I keep it in, you know, my higher power's hands, whatever that may be, you know. Whatever happens, happens. I do know I'm learning a lot about how, and trying to figure out how to stick up for myself. I found Because I've never wanted to make people angry. I've never wanted to be. I've always been kind of like that weakling, and I'm straight up honest, you know. I don't like to cause waves and stuff, and it's been tough. I've having to do a lot of cutting myself off, all just reflecting, trying to figure out my life, trying to figure out how I can reconnect. You know, my daughters, I'm proud of them. They're all doing great. I've told you guys about my oldest one. You know, it's just this thing that she was always stronger than me and so much of everything. Because I was, you know, I was supposed to protect them, and I didn't. And it's so hard. It's so hard for me to think about that and look at myself and think, you know, how did I let all this happen? And all I could do is say, I'm sorry, ask for forgiveness, and move on from here. That's the only thing I can do. I started trying to look for, you know, alternatives, and it's a lot for me just to get out. And I found, you know, there's a pool down the road that I go through for from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. I mean, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. It's an hour every day, aqua size, and I hurt, it hurts. But I know that my body was immobile for so long that, you know, now that I'm having to, now I'm getting back into exercising and having to feel it all, is tough. Because I, you know, of course I don't want to be on medications like forever. I've got to take my blood thinner. I have to do my transfusions and infusions. And I also have to have an inhaler now, you know, due to the damage that COVID had given my lungs. So there is a whole bunch. But anywho, I was trying to, well, no, okay, so this here we're gonna go back to this. I went to, you know, there's, I try to, you know, I just want to be able to be okay and help people, and me just make, you know, be able to survive. So a lot of the people were welcoming over there at the pool. But there's a lady that, I mean, she just took one look at me, and I think she made up her mind and has just been mean to me, and I let her run me off this last Friday because I've never been able to really stick up for myself, and I'm trying. It's not easy, but I'm trying. But anyway, guys, you know, everything that's been, it's just like there's so much cool stuff, you know, that I'm learning now, and everything, and being able to just kind of watch videos and do videos and make my videos and watch other people and stuff. But anyways, just been listening to, you know, you all know that I had Music to Be Murdered By. Oh, my M shirt. My M, guys. Oh, it's in the front room. Hold on, guys. Hold on. There is the, you know, okay, Music to Be Murdered By, you know, that's my shady, that's my M&M, you know, and I said I was hospitalized for so long, I didn't get to do the reactions that I wanted to, and also now the, you know, the side B and stuff, but Godzilla is when I've been listening to on repeat because I've been just like, oh, dude. And then the videos and stuff like that come with it. But this is crazy. I love watching M. A party across between a zombie apocalypse and Big Bobby. The brain healing, which is probably the same reason I wrestle with mania shades and this bitch I'm posse. Consider it to cost me a costly mistake if they sleep in on me. The hell's gonna get insomnia, ADHD, hydroxychloroquine. That's like a posse. So, okay, y'all know I suck. I'm gonna get there, but this to watch him, cause me, I'm as old as him. He's a little bit older than me, but been following him from the start. Said it's like, you know, to still see people that have been able to react and take the lyrics and learn and grow and be fans of, you know, hip hop and not just. There's just so much that this one, and I was like, no, I'm gonna get this one, you know? So, it's cool.
vacate, melee, finna set it like a play date, better vacate, retreat like a vacate, mayday. This beat is cray cray, ray jay, aj, 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 laughing all the way to the bank, I spray fling.
Without looking at it, whenever there was a H A H A H A laughing, ha ha ha, I can't believe that took me a minute. You know, guys, I was like, oh, Stephanie, really? Oh, come on. You should have known that, but I didn't. You know, was it the lyrics? I was listening to it. I didn't pull the lyrics up, the lyrics or anything up. But this is so cool.
Things that cannot tame or placate the monster.
You get out of my way, I can see you to a monster. I'm no more good today, but it matters to a monster. When the moon shines like Ice Road Truckers. You ever watch Ice Road Truckers? I've watched Ice Road Truckers because it's like, oh my god, they go out to these remote areas like so far off the grid and stuff, and they're driving over, you know, frozen lakes and stuff in these big old semis and trying to get supplies to some of the most desolate areas there are. And I couldn't even imagine thinking about, you know, oh my god, what if the ice broke? Or but you could just think, you visualize when Juice WRLD's over here talking about Ice Road Truckers, when the moon shines bright, you know, because you know you that glare off the ice is just so just so bright. Lick the balls, and the ladies, girls are there licking a basketball in the store. I mean, you know, for him to still be able to have fun with it all, is just the coolest thing ever. You know, I wanted to see, because I watch one of my favorite reactors is No Life Shack, but he was talking. I mean, I was watching one of them today when he was talking about when with stuff with Rihanna and the leaked song and stuff like that, and how he apologized in Zeus over it and stuff like that. You know, admit when you're wrong and go forward. And that's it's just us. It's life. We're family. We're human. I make mistakes every day, guys. Every day. And at the end of the day, we just got to try to do the best, be the best versions of ourselves, or our authentic self. But I was listening to him, and he was talking about, Eminem was talking about relapse around the, when he was having to try to learn how to re-rap and use words again and stuff like that because of the drugs and stuff. I understand that. It is very, very real. Very real. Altered state of mind is always very, very hard. Something that I've struggled with. I mean, the medication, the stuff like that that I've struggled with, because I'm not good with pain. You know, it's like when he did the So Cold, that remix, and he says, if I could rewind time like a tape in a boombox for every pill or Percocet that I ate, cut down on the volume, I would have heard everything, but death is so definite. They got me all hooked up to some machine. I love you, Bean. I want you to know I was struggling. But that's me, guys. I was always afraid to do anything that I shouldn't have been doing growing up. I never drank beer. I never smoked cigarettes. I never tried to do drugs. But yet, I ended up, you know, having to try to recover off of pain medications. And I was able to get off of them for a long time. And then whenever this happened again with me, now I'm back on them. And it's hard to admit that, but I have to so I can function. But I know that there's alternatives now. When I'm ready to get off of them, my doctor, we know how to get off of it. Or, you know, how to taper off and get off of it. So it scared me. It scared me, you know. It scared me. The whole thing is just scary. But, you know, I've let fear roll me for so long. And it's so hard to understand that. But, you know, just there's so much. So much. And I want to learn, and I want to grow, and I want to be happy. I don't want to be scared anymore. And I'm taking those necessary steps now to be able to, and hopefully start learning how to edit videos better for you guys, but better content. But it's never been about like trying to make it big in the YouTube world or money or anything. It's about me looking for help and reaching people and them helping me in the process. And this is where I'm at, like going back to NF, going back to Eminem, going back to Linkin Park, going back to the music that heals me, and I gotta feel it. And it's hard to realize you have to feel it to heal it. You know, I'm working with my oldest daughter. I know we're always still gonna be have hard times. My middle daughter, my youngest. But there's where we're at, and all I can do is learn and grow and live well so that everybody that worked so hard for me to survive didn't do it in vain. So, you know, basically this is just it. When we get back to the last end, this is going to be different. It's not a, like a whole reaction or whatever, but... Man, you know, it's like to catch all that, you just can't, all in, you know, I've probably heard it 1,000 times, this song, and I'm still having to try to figure a lot of it out, and I get so excited when I catch a line or a bar or something that I couldn't before, or that I catch something that somebody else didn't, and it makes me feel so good because my brain is working again. But guys, I'm going to do this one, and then I'm going to do my reactions. I am going to start seeing how I can edit videos and do just better by you guys. I promise, and I hope you all have a great weekend. Let me know. Help me out, guys, with what you guys know and what I don't know, and we're going to get there. And we're going to get there. I'm going to get out today and go with my friend. And I'm excited about that. So, so I'm hoping tonight or in the morning I can start doing better content. I know that I wake up, I don't know how I'm going to wake up because my immune system is so shot that I catch everything under the sun. So it's just, you know, being the ability to get up and go and stuff. But guys, thank you so much. We're getting it going. We're getting there. I love you all.